Hello, I'm Sin with the OSINT Dojo. In this video, we're going to cover how to solve one of the OSINT Dojo's recent OSINT challenges. We've recently had a few users reach out to us and ask if we do some quick videos showcasing the steps needed to solve some of our past challenges. We're going to start off with a recent challenge, as it seemed to give quite a few people some problems. So, we have this photo here, and we're being asked to determine where this photo was taken. And while it may look difficult to determine at first, there are a few things that might help point us into the right direction. So, the very first thing we want to do is we want to open this image full size so that we can get a really good look at the details. And while it doesn't make this image any larger than what we have in the original Twitter post, we can now zoom in using the scroll wheel on our mouse to allow us to see some of these details a little bit better. One thing worth pointing out here are the types of plants that we can see, which somewhat suggests that this could be in a warmer area of the world. We also see the street sign here of an E with a line through it, as well as a sign and some graffiti tags here off to the right. Now, the latter won't help us too much for locating this image, but it would be helpful in a case if we were trying to determine, say, when exactly the photo was taken, as street art is often fluid and changes quite often. And finally, we also have some letters here that we can see in the reflection of these windows. Let's start narrowing down our possible locations using the information that we just touched on. With just a little bit of Google dorking, we can see that our street sign is possibly a no parking sign found in Mexico, which does match up with our belief of this photo being from a warmer climate. One thing to consider, however, is that this sign may not be distinct only to Mexico, and that it's possible that similar signs exist in other Spanish-speaking countries. So now we've narrowed it down to likely being either in Mexico, or at the very least, another warm Spanish-speaking country. The next thing we can do is inspect the letters we see in the reflections of these windows here. Although we cannot see all of the letters, we can tell that there is no letter above the first one, which appears to be an S. It's also possible that there's a letter below the ones that are shown here. And based on this letter spacing, it is likely that there is another letter here between the letter S and the letter C. Now, at first glance, the last visible letter could be either a P or an R, but if we zoom in, we can see based on what is still visible, this is likely going to be the letter P. Let's use this information to query Google Maps and see what turns up. What we're going to do is plug in vowels into the space where we don't know what the character is, and search specifically in areas of Spanish-speaking countries to see if any return results. Searching for SACAP returns some results that are unlikely to be related based on what we know about the language, such as those down here in South Africa. We do, however, have a result from Mexico, but if we check the thumbnail image, we can see that this is most likely not the correct area. We also have some results here over in Brazil, which, although they do speak Portuguese, it's still worth checking out since it is a Romance language like Spanish. We have just one result here that looks like it is worth checking out on Street View, though a quick look around tells us this is also likely not the correct place either. So let's zoom out and let's try another vowel here, which does give us a few more results, none of which though are in Mexico. Using the thumbnails, we can rule some of them out, but for others, we do have to drop into Street View to confirm whether or not they are a match. So, we're just going to keep checking through these results. Unfortunately, many of the ones that we are seeing here are using a thumbnail that doesn't really help us much regarding what their building actually looks like. So, what we're going to have to do is just continue going along through these results and checking each one of them in Google Street View to make sure that we can rule them out as a possible match. As you can see, this can take quite a bit of time to go through all the results, but eventually, we do run across one result here in the city of Quito that looks like it could be a match for our original photo. I actually nearly overlooked the correct location as I initially dropped my street view onto the incorrect side of the street. Once we get ourselves oriented and dropped on the correct side of the street, we can start seeing similarities if we cross-reference our original photo. Moving down the street a bit, we can look back and see that the letters found on the building do indeed spell S-E-C-A-P. And they do match those initially found in our reference photo. Moving down the street a little bit more, we see other points of reference in our photo as well, including the original foliage, as well as the street sign, which, for whatever reason, appears to be redacted in Street View. Now, our final confirmation that this is indeed the correct location, all we need to do is simply adjust ourselves on the street to show the same letters reflected in the building as we saw in our original photo. And that's pretty much it. Hopefully now, you can see how just a little bit of information from a photo can be used to narrow down its exact location, using nothing more than Google, as well as just a little bit of time.